Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for Neeraj Pangal!
नीरज पंगाल की वापसी हो चुकी है एमएफएन में। अर्जुन, 2022 इनके लिए बहुत ही बढ़िया था और उसके बाद 2023 में जब इन्होंने अपना प्रो डेब्यू किया वो भी बहुत ही शानदार था। ये भी एमएफएन कंटेंडर्स 2022 के स्नातक हैं। He graduated from MFN contenders in 2022, made his pro debut in 2023, had his first win against Oves Yakub, which was an excellent win. He pulled a standing guillotine. Then he fought Digambar Singh Rawat, suffered a loss. He's had an excellent camp, trained again at Boreas Cove in Gurgaon. And tonight, he's here to show the world that he's one of the best lightweight prospects in the country.
I mean, these Boreas Cove guys are doing something right because the grappling has reached another level. We saw Oves Yakub in the previous fight. The way his grappling has improved is just incredible. It's world class. India has reached a new level where our athletes are proving more and more that we are no less than the international standard. And that's what we're getting to see here at Matrix Fight Night. In this promotion, they're seeing only world class athletes. And Neeraj Pangal again has a great, great chance to see. It's going to be, you know, do you think Oves Yakub will be watching this fight? Just after he won, maybe look for a rematch?
Well, yes, he may look for a rematch because that was one crazy submission that I saw here at MFN. You know, standing guillotine, and after the win, the way Neeraj Pangal was thumping the cage was absolutely crazy. You know, he looked like a beast. He looked like a roaring beast.
Well, you find out I had a chance to speak with him earlier. He's saying he's looking for a knockout this time around. His last fight was unfortunately a loss. But you know what? Winning and losing is part of the sport. He needs to use his striking, mix up his combinations, go to the head, body, mix up his kicks, make sure his strikes, whatever he throws, lands clean. Precision striking is the name of the game. And keep this fight on the feet, keep it moving, establish range and control, and look for that opening where he can land a clean, precise shot and get the win.
Neeraj Pangal ne apne career mein दो फाइटर्स का सामना किया है, ओवेस याकूब और दिगंबर सिंह रावत। आज इनका सामना है आकिब अली से। अर्जुन, आकिब एक बहुत ही डायनामिक फाइटर है, यू नो द गाइस इज स्ट्राइकर हु कैन ग्रैपल, सो इट्स गोना बी एक्सेलेंट टू सी हाउ एंड व्हाट ही डज टुनाइट हियर एट एमएफएन 14।
एंड हिज ओपोनेंट मेकिंग हिज वे टू द केज, आकिब अली।
Aqib Ali, another graduate of MFN Contenders batch of 2022, walks in to the MFN cage once again. He last fought Digambar at MFN 10, suffered a split decision loss. So that was a very close fight. So both these fighters have suffered a loss at the hands of Digambar Singh Rawat, who's one of the rising prospects in the country. And tonight, whosoever wins, I think that person is going to call out Digambar Singh Rawat once again.
Find out, we've got both fighters who have defeated somebody on this card, and it's going to be interesting to see what happens. Aqib Ali though has a great chance as we get closer and closer towards the co-main and main event. We are not very far away from the two titles that will be contested today. But Aqib, man, he's got, I don't know what to say about him, a fighter that can chain wrestling and striking together becomes very, very dangerous, because wrestlers control where they keep the fight and strikers decide when to end the fight.
Well, very appropriately said, but I've been watching this kid over the last couple of years fight in the local circuit before he bagged the prestigious MFN contract at MFN Contenders. Aqib is a Kyokushin black belt with excellent jiu-jitsu. So that makes the difference. You know, he's a Kyokushin guy who can actually grapple.
You know, karatekas are known for their range control. They step in and out of range very, very well. And they move laterally beautifully. They don't circle out like most fighters, left and right. They hop and move laterally. So it's going to be interesting how he utilizes his range and his combination. Step in and out, land, use his slick striking and chain his striking with his grappling. Look to take this fight to the ground, maybe submit him, maybe keep it striking. Sometimes when you see two grapplers take each other on, you see a striking fight. We don't know what's going to happen here, but he's such a well-rounded athlete that he gets to dictate and choose what's going to happen.
एक मोमेंट वहां था अर्जुन इनकी फाइट में जहां पे ही ऑलमोस्ट हैड दिगंबर वाया नी बार, सो हैड ही पुल दैट वुड हैव बीन एक्सेलेंट। चलिए देखते हैं टेल ऑफ द टेप। ब्लू कॉर्नर में है नीरज पंगाल 28 वर्षीय और इनके विरुद्ध है आकिब अली 27 वर्षीय। 2 सेंटीमीटर की रीच एडवांटेज यहां नीरज पंगाल को और दोनों ही फाइटर्स का स्टाइल एमएमए।
Ladies and gentlemen, first we introduce the blue corner. He holds a professional record of 1 win and 1 loss. He weighed in at 70.1 kilograms, fighting out of Warriors Cove and representing Haryana. Make some noise for Neeraj Pangal! And his opponent fighting out of the red corner. His record, 5 wins, 3 losses. He weighed in at 70 kilograms, fighting out of Ronin MMA, representing West Bengal. Give it up for Aqib Ali! Ladies and gentlemen, the referee, Ranjit.
Follow my instruction all the time. If I say stop, stop the fight. If you want to touch gloves, touch gloves. Back to your corners.
Here we go. Round number one in this lightweight contest. Neeraj Pangal taking on Aqib Ali. A lot of fighters represented by Warriors Cove here tonight.
Well, to me, it looked, the last couple of fights, it looked like this is Warriors Cove versus rest of the world.
Certainly seems that way, and as vocal as they are sitting right next to me.
Aqib Ali starting the round with a low kick.
Pangal in the white trunks, Aqib in the green and black. It's going to be interesting to see how they start this fight. Is they going to shoot instantly? Nice leg kick there. Aqib Ali trying to gauge that range and distance.
अर्जुन, जैसे मैंने आपको बताया कि आकिब अली का जो फाइटिंग स्टाइल है बहुत ही यूनिक है। He takes a little bit of time to warm up. In the first round, what he does is assess his opponent. Second round onwards, he starts throwing strikes, and he throws in a lot of variation in terms of strikes. As I told you, he's a Kyokushin black belt, so he brings in that strength to his fighting.
Good check there a moment ago by Pangal there. Check kicks are, when you kick an opponent, the kick hurts both parties at the same time. It hurts your shin as well as hurts the opponent. But very nice low leg kick and check by Aqib Ali. Good inside leg kick there, but good defense by Pangal. Slow start, both fighters showing a lot of respect to one another, taking their time, gauging their timing and distance. But Ali doing a good job trying to cut him off and push him towards the back of the cage. Good job, and step forward.
Oof. Oh, look at that power. No, look at that power.
No setup needed. You just look to wing that right hand.
Well, Neeraj Pangal literally packs a punch. We've seen him fighting at MFN, throwing in some crazy leather.
I'm waiting to see how long it's going to take Pangal to take this fight to the ground.
Pangal is staying a little bit patient here, you know, trying to get his moment.
No, it's usually a function of the respect that they have for their opponents. Is they both are taking their time to figure out what their strategy is going to be, because they don't want to step in and make a wrong move, especially at this level. Oh, good front team.
Oh,
slams into the mat. Up kick there from this position, and Pangal lets him back up. Interesting. That's what we talked about. The constant threat, ability to be able to strike and then be able to variate and convert that into a takedown and use his superior grappling at the same time is an absolute virtue. Good leg kick by Pangal.
Well, that definitely has shocked Aqib Ali and slowed his momentum.
Shoots immediately, gets a body lock. Trying to drag him. Aqib now pushing him up against the fence here, right in front of us. And Pangal trying to sweep the leg. He's got a body lock, trying to sweep the leg from here. He's got an over under. He's got a good clasp of his hands. Nice knees to the leg. Slowly. Very nice. I love the blunt shots to the side of the shin.
Pretty intelligent here. Intelligent fighting here by Neeraj Pangal.
Very nice knee there. Foot stomps as his corner screams. Nice kick to the shin there. Slowly peppering down. Very nice drag. Beautiful body lock trip. Takes him straight down, and now he's going to slowly get to work.
Well, some brute strength here by Neeraj Pangal.
But you can see the way Ali is moving. He's going to try and use a headlock. But no, he's going to try to use that overhook there to try and drag his hips out. But Pangal has got a hold of his leg. He's got a hold of his right leg, which is not going to allow him to slide that leg out and turn his hips. Very good top control by Pangal.
Pretty dangerous position here for Ali.
Watch out for those elbows from this position as Pangal is going to look to pressure him now. Nice shots there. Good defense by Ali.
Oh!
Very nice. Very nice upkick attempt. Very nice upkick attempt.
Will you only get to see such kind of things, such dynamic striking here at Matrix Fight Night?
I'm sorry, but I've got to make a reference again. Only Anthony Pettis did that so far. Very interesting first round. Back and forth action. And great action so far only at Matrix Fight Night 14. As we get ready for round number two.
Oh! Well, that's an excellent round here.
I think that was a bit of a weird accident. They opened the cage door and he fell through it.
A bit of faux-pas here.
No, but that could have been dangerous because the fighter can hurt himself. He needs to be careful. But take a look at the highlights of that round. He tries to throw deep to the body, grabs him, slams him to the mat, lands some good shots there, good control from the top by Neeraj Pangal. You can see all that grappling training there. He hooks the leg, drags into the ground. Beautifully done. Great technique by Pangal. Maintains that top position. Lands some good elbows here, but very Anthony Pettis-esque high up kick from the bottom. But to his detriment, gets taken down again. Great round.
Well, as I said in the beginning, Aqib Ali takes a little bit of time to warm up. That's his fighting style. So first round is always a warm up for him. Second round is when he starts to begin the show. Round number two in this lightweight contest between Aqib Ali in the red corner and Neeraj Pangal in the blue corner.
Here we go, round number two. It was an interesting first round though. It's going to be interesting to see what strategy Aqib Ali employs moving forward now that he knows that he has a threat of a takedown to contend with as well.
Well, we call it Kensukutugeri, you know, that kind of knee kick that Aqib Ali is throwing in. It's a little bit devastating.
It's a side kick to the knee or oblique kick, in fact. Very, very...
It's painful.
It's a painful and very...
Oh!
Very nice. Left and right. Got his attention there immediately. Look at that. He's limping on that leg. He's hurt his leg. You can see the way he's moving on that leg, which forces Aqib Ali to look for the takedown. I think his left leg, he might have caught a nerve on that left leg. You watch, if you get a replay at the end of the round, I'm going to show you. It's where that foot landed on the shin, on the thigh. You see right under the knee there. And he immediately limped on that rear leg. There you go, beautiful strategy. You can see how the way Neeraj is stomping on that. He needs to push him off here and get back to striking range because he had a lot of success landing those low kicks there. There you go, he's trying to turn him around, but Aqib Ali is trying to maintain that strength in that position.
Well, for sure, Neeraj Pangal dominating Aqib Ali in terms of strength. He's got the back.
Very good drag down there. Aqib Ali's leg is hurt here, and this might be an opening that Neeraj Pangal could look for. Try to land some ground and pound, maybe work some hooks, but right now he's riding out his back.
Well, excellent transition here from that turtle position by Aqib Ali. But he's still vulnerable.
I wish Neeraj Pangal would just back up his hips, stand up, because that leg is not going to be in optimal condition. That leg is less than at optimum capacity, and he should look to continue the attack on that shin, on that calf.
We still have 2.5 minutes to go into this round.
That's a lifetime. But he's slowly, this is the difference between the camp that does coaching in a certain manner versus a fighter that is not coached as well, because this methodical slow breakdown, like we say, it's the slow knife that cuts the deepest and the slowest. It's that slow breakdown where you pull the will out of a fighter by badgering him, not allowing him an inch to get off his back, slowly breaking him down and apart. And that's what we're seeing done by Neeraj here.
Well, Arjun, the irony is both these guys wanted to train at the same camp. However,
that's not possible now, is it?
Well, that's the reality. However, Neeraj landed there first with his bags.
Well, first come, first serve, What can you say? But he's staying patient from this position. I just wonder if he's given him enough time to recover from that leg injury.
Neeraj Pangal clearly dominating from top. He's put Aqib Ali in a very tough spot here.
I'm wishing that he could just start posturing up here, because Ali is not looking to sweep. He's in side control now. He could look to tuck his arm underneath and look for a crucifix from this position.
Or maybe transition into an arm triangle. Oh, he's got an excellent side control here. Aqib Ali still trying to defend.
Aqib trying to get a hold of his hips, but Pangal, he pulls it very nicely, pulls it back to guard though. That was a bit sloppy by Pangal because he let go of side control.
Oh, excellent fighting from the ground by Aqib Ali.
Aqib Ali trying to land some offense of his own from the bottom there. But Pangal having none of it, still got his head in his chest, but not seeing too much offense from this position here. Good guard by Ali so far. Few shots by Neeraj Pangal, 10 seconds to go in this second round. It's going to be interesting to see how he gets back up though. He's still wobbly on that left leg. You can see he's favoring that left leg a little bit as he walks to his corner. Interesting. Let's take a look at the highlights of the second round. It started off with that 1-2 combination which got Ali's attention. It's that leg kick. Watch that leg kick. Immediately buckled him. And I wish he continued. He might have had a stoppage from that point there. But he decided to take the fight to the ground and probably have a different strategy, trying to sap his attention, sap his energy out completely. But it's going to be interesting to see, because he didn't offer a lot of offense from this point. It was more defensive grappling from Ali. And now we move on to round number three and figure out what the strategy is moving forward.
राउंड थ्री में आकिब अली को थोड़ा अग्रेशन दिखाना होगा, थोड़ा दिखाना होगा जांबाजी, ताकि ये राउंड नीरज पंगाल के फेवर में स्कोर ना हो. अभी तक नीरज पंगाल ने डोमिनेट किया है.
I wonder how the scoring will go, though. It's going to be interesting to see, because I don't know if the judges are, you know, how they're scoring it. Yes, top control is one thing, but it also depends on what you do with top control at the same time.
Let's move over to the third round of this epic lightweight battle. We've got Aqib Ali in the red corner, and he takes on Neeraj Pangal in the blue corner.
Hey, watch that left leg, though. I still think he's moving gingerly on it. I want to see, he's not moving forward, and he's switching stances. That's the first sign. When a fighter switches stances to protect the rear leg, it's a first sign of damage. I'm waiting to see if Neeraj is going to attack that rear leg, because I feel there's something there. He's not threatening to check it.
I think यहाँ पे आकिब अली गलती कर रहे हैं बगैर किसी सेटअप के डिस्टेंस क्लोज कर रहे हैं और हाथ भी गिरा रहे हैं so that may prove to be a little bit devastating and he gets down. आकिब अली दोबारा से टर्टल पोजीशन में बैक से कंट्रोल कर रहे हैं नीरज पंगाल और कुछ स्ट्राइक्स भी फेंक रहे हैं.
He's got back control again and he's got dominant back control from this point, but Ali is doing a good job controlling the wrist. He's not letting himself take some damage from this point. He's slapping him with the back of his glove. Ali trying to roll now. But Neeraj Pangal trying to roll with him in the same position. Oh, look at this though. He might be a bit high on the back.
Look at the
No, wait, hang on. He might have a hold of that. If he can stretch out that thigh, if he can stretch out that calf, he needs to be careful and protect that leg, because if he can stretch out that calf, he might look for a knee bar.
Well, excellent defense here by Neeraj Pangal.
And Neeraj Pangal realizes this. He's in a bit of an awkward situation here.
Arjun, इसी के बारे में मैंने बात की थी पिछले फाइट में. आकिब के हमें यही देखने को मिला. He almost had Digambar into this knee bar.
Now check it out. Now if he locks his hand here on his other hand and pulls on the calf of his opponent, and if it stretches out, he can stretch out to a knee bar from this position. Wait, whoa, one second. What? That was an offensive position for a submission. I can't. Anyway, the action continues.
Well, it is what it is. Both these fighters onto their feet once again.
Good leg kick there again. That leg kick. I wish he would follow up with the leg kicks over and over, because he's had so much success with that low leg kick. Back to the ground in half guard here. Ali again with no answer to the grappling. Was in an advantageous position there a moment ago, honestly. And I don't know why referee Ranjit stood them up. Couple of minutes remaining in this third and final round. Slow and steady work done by Neeraj Pangal, not taking too many risks, realizing that from the last exchange that Ali still has a lot of fight left in him and can try and sneak out a submission from any position, staying patient in his guard.
Well, that was a lucky save by the ref here, because oh man,
very nice
shot strikes.
No, it's, you know, it may not be the most attractive form of fighting, but it is certainly decisive, and it's definitive, because there'll be no doubt in the mind of the judges.
For sure, and this is no jiu-jitsu, you know, this is MMA. It's really tough to pull a knee bar in MMA and protect yourself from all the strikes pounding onto you.
Well, we wouldn't know now, because the position changed before anything worked on it. I mean, it's because it's, you know, it was a position of advance. When it's like having your right hand under someone's neck and then making somebody stop you from that point. It's ridiculous.
Referee Ranjit putting both the fighters to neutral position once again. Dono hi fighters apne pairon pe dobara se. Oh,
nice ball kick to the back. Ali's legs are battered at this point. He can barely move in a straight line. You can see he's light on that front foot now. Nice thumping outside left leg kick. You can see the welt on those legs now. But he needs to watch out.
Oh!
Kind of standing hammer
fist. Oh, man.
slugfest now. It's certainly unique striking I'm seeing here. 10 seconds to go. He's trying to slap him.
That's some crazy hammer fist here by Neeraj Pangal.
He's trying to slap him. Stockton stands with his finger.
That's some crazy fighting between both these guys.
I don't know why he's so upset, but it ended incredibly. As you can see him celebrating in front of us right here, his team. He's a charged up, fired up champ who's put on a great show here. Great job by Pangal. He put a stamp on the fight.
So excited he jumps out of the cage.
Incredible. Let's take a look at the highlights of the third round.
Look at the takedown here by Neeraj Pangal, and Aqib Ali trying to defend it, but still gets taken down almost.
Neeraj Pangal did a great job. He followed his instructions of his camp, gets the win. That is the most important thing. But this is what I'm saying here. This was a submission attempt area where I saw a possibility of something developing. I wish the referee would have let it go a little longer. I really did, because that might have, you know, made this. You never know how outcomes change in a fight. But these were, I think, they were more slaps than anything else. And he was trying to egg him on in the last 20 seconds. Crazy. And the end, of course, a little bit of a heated moment between them. Thankfully, it was not shown on national television.
Those hammer fists and the open slaps, you know, they took Aqib Ali by surprise. He didn't know what was coming in. Hailstorms. Massive show of respect between both these fighters.
Yeah, you know, heated moments during battle are possible and are normal. It happens in the heat of the moment, but you can see that there's always sportsmanship in the sport and it always exists here. But let's go inside the ring with Jared Kyle, the voice, for the final decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of action, we go to the judges' scorecards. Judge Ben and Rupendra scored the bout 30-27. Judge Manas scored the bout 30-26 for your winner. By unanimous decision, Neeraj Pangal!